friends, we have with us a very special guest, a techie turned lake conservationist from Bengaluru who believes it's time to care before streams are bare. So let us welcome Anand Maligawad, also known as the Lake Man of India. Let me give a brief introduction of our special guest. Anand is working towards rejuvenating lakes and reservoirs in and around the city of Bengaluru to ease the growing water crisis. Through constant efforts, Anand has revived over 10 lakes and plans to rejuvenate about 35 more lakes by 2025. His earliest project, Kailans Ahali Lake near Anekal, a 36-acre water body was restored in just 45 days, followed by creation of two Japanese Miyawaki forests on the lake. His dream is to give Bengaluru the best wetlands in the country. Mr. Anand, I hand it over to you now.
Thank you so much. Thanks for giving me opportunity to meet all of you. And it's a wonderful session. Like, especially like this, I feel very proud that if you see in Mahabharata, like Indra, Kandavaprastha, how they converted as a Indraprastha. So same way, like entire real estate today, whatever Bangalore is become Silicon Valley, not only because of IT, it's the beauty which, you know, you all people put a lot of effort and built this, you can see kingdom. And also, if you see, like compared to old days, now if you see, I visited so many modern properties, like in terms of designing and other things, and these are all much advanced. I can see a lot of greenery inside the campus, what you people are building. So biggest thing is like, for example, whatever villages and other things, you know, if you see, there is no much trees. Most of them are, again, it is fully built with everywhere house. And one tree is not there, in fact. But if you see complete, now modern, all the infrastructure, what you people are building, highest native species of trees, rainwater harvesting, like most of them are doing a sewage water treatment and they are reutilizing for their afforestation, all those things. And basically, like we need a wealthy country, means we should have also have a better infrastructure, which you are putting a lot of effort. And along with you, see, you build a nest for the people. So, but see, healthy nest and wealthy nest you are building. So along with you, I am also working lakes around you, and all are in a pathetic condition because of so many reasons, you know, the sewage or the encroachment, and so many issues are there. Because of that, you know, like I am also putting my effort to see that there will be win-win situation. You build a nest for the people, I build a nest for the birds, environment, and other thing. See, water is the very, very much needed and essential. Air, water, food, then shelter. Fourth, shelter, you are doing it. Air, water, food, you know, we are trying to do it in such a way that all, you know, residents of, you know, planet, all individual citizens, they should get a abundant, you know, best quality water to for a life. So this is how, like last 5 years I have been working on lake restoration. I am trying to rebuild the lake in a ecological way. It will not be much, you know, like a fancy things or this thing. And they're all ecological hotspot. See, in your campuses, you are building a beautiful, you know, like a infrastructure. Same thing need not to copy and paste inside the lake also. That is a simple, with let people with play with mud, let them play with the dirt water, like muddy water. Then there will be like a native species of big trees. All those things we are trying to put in such a way that, so it is a kind of hand-in-hand work. So you build an infrastructure for people, I build a nature. That is how. And also we need a lot of support from your side to see that, you know, we will work together. And see, you built a lot of, so many houses and housing, like Lakeview apartments and all. So there also, please join us and let's work together and see that nearby lakes and empty lands, we'll build a forest there. And see that we will bring our ecology back. See, in fact, communities, what you built, they are having a water body inside. There is a forest inside. I find a lot of birds, a lot of landscaping. and beautiful everything you built. But when you go out, then there will be on dead lake. So that dead lake will going to give adverse effect for you. So rather than that, let's all work together, see that, you know, we'll have a better water body, better infrastructure around us also, so that we'll have a green planet. This is the concept I'm working. And most of the lakes I rejuvenated with the CSR funding support, and some of them are the crowdfunding support. In fact, a lot of resident welfare associations, you know, they are supporting me to rejuvenate all these lakes. So whole idea is that let's build, you know, livable green planet. For that, we need your support also. And in fact, I seen so many builders, like architects, they are most of them into like ecological, buildings, like ecological infrastructure they're building. I go any campus or anything, so beautiful, so amazing. Like, for example, around 50 acres of one property you develop. Earlier, maybe 50 trees or 100 trees would have been there. But now thousands of trees you are planting. So much of rainwater harvesting you are doing it. So much of, effort you are putting into, bringing back our better home. So this is directly or indirectly, you are not only just creating a concrete, jungle, you are also creating a best infrastructure and best, facilities for the humankind, as well as you build for humans, but there will be a lot of birds. You can't stop them. They are coming. They are enjoying. So indirectly, you are helping them. And you are creating inside some fountains, water body or something else. There are a lot of pigeons, parrots. So many things are coming. They are also enjoying. Thank you so much for that. And the only thing I request is, let's all work together to rejuvenate the lake, create a forest. So that is the theme I am trying to insist for you. And most of the houses you are building is eco-friendly and other things. That is all great. So let's all together, work and see that we will have a better place to stay in. Not only like Bangalore, you people are always all over the world, you are there. Your presence is there, especially in India. So every state, wherever you get opportunity, please rejuvenate one on lake along with you. And we will be with you. And let's work together and see that we will have a better harmony. This is what I'm trying to tell. And thank you so much and wonderful time, like Sapna Madam and all. Thanks for Reality Plus and all the entrepreneurs that you have created such a wonderful platform. And you've given me opportunity to talk to you and spend some time with you. So thank you so much.
Anand, wonderful to know that you have got support from other segments of the society as well. But what were the challenges that you had to face? Were there while you were looking at rejuvenating these lakes?
Yeah. See, basically, most of the Bangalore, we had about 1,000 plus lakes. So left out is around 450. See, rapid urbanization, you can't stop it, because in village there is no job. There is no proper, infrastructure. Generally, people study and they come to city. And this Bangalore is the place for, not Bangalore, any metro cities, they are the employment generation place. Like a real estate is given highest employment for the people, rural people. Like close together, people, you given employment. They all come. They want to settle here. They want to be here. In this process, what happens? People say concrete jungle. I don't feel like it is a concrete jungle. See, you see 100 acres of property, if you see anywhere, earlier maybe 20, I seen Bangalore from 1996, maybe 50, 60, 100 trees were there. But now you go to any builders, so much of, I also stay in one of the community. I find thousands of trees here, rainwater harvesting, then segregation of the waste, everything is fantastic. And a lot of birds, and we have an artificial lake here, where there are a lot of fishes, everything. See, that is why first word I told, it is instead of Kandava Prastha, it has become Indraprastha. It is all because of you people and your sector. They brought up to this level. I'm very happy, very proud. In fact, I'm speaking to so many builders, so many real estate companies and so many architects. And when I'm discussing with them, their aim is like, we want to create a forest, sir. We want to have this kind of habitat, that kind of. See, those days are gone. Like building just some structures and I want to sell it. Buyers also don't buy. Now, buyers are also very choosy. You have a lot of greenery, rainwater harvesting, so many things they question, right? So, like that, industry also changed. Industry is too matured. If you see, what are the facilities not available in the government area, like villages, and other wards and all, all facility available in the campus. Everything is available in terms of fitness, in terms of environment, in terms of walking track, jogging. Everything is built for a better livable place. So biggest challenge is like a sewage water. Sewage water, what happens? See, any campus, even my, I also staying in one of the community, whatever excess water come after the treatment, right? After the treatment, how much you can use it for landscaping gardening, that is coming out. Okay. Once coming out, there has to be government, some systems and some regulations that in particular area, they have to collect and they have to again treat and use it. Okay. But some of the highest sewage is coming for me is villages. Villages, there is no treatment system at all. There is no any system. We have everything mix and coming. So ultimately, victims are becoming like real estate companies or builders. But fact is, 60% is coming from village, which is directly government is responsible for it. So I think, so all we together and try to do something and change the scenario. That is the this thing.
Okay. That's you know, great to hear, because we have, you know, some developers here who have joined with us, and you know, it's good to hear that the developer community is doing their bit, as you mentioned. Yes. With rainwater harvesting, whether it is green, whether it is, you know, treatment of water, but probably some more government policies are required in general. Yes. For, you know, other segments also, because as you mentioned, in the rural areas, that kind of awareness is not there, and that kind of regulations are not there.
Not there.
Which need to be there. So that was, you know, thank you so much for sharing your wise words and sharing with us how we need to work together to save our planet. And, you know, before we let you go, we also had this, you know, COP26 recently, where India has made, you know, big promises on cutting down on carbon emissions and planting trees. Reviving our water bodies is one of the ways to go about it. What more can we do? You know, developer community, as you said, they are doing their bit. Others are doing their bit. You are doing your own, you know, initiatives. As common citizens, what more can we do?
See, common citizens, only thing is like modern amenities. I know everybody is doing rainwater harvesting. Without rain harvesting, you can't sustain. You know water, how much expensive, borewells also, you know. That is why we do rainwater harvesting everywhere. We are planting trees, everything in this thing. We are also doing a treatment and we are utilizing, there is one. So that is all going on. But it has to be replicated. See, what builders are building and so much of infrastructure, it is not even 20-25%. We are still 75% along with us, we are living with them. Slums, all those surroundings, like unorganized infrastructures, we have to all together to should take care and fight with the government and create our policies. And we should be actively involved and see that those also will change. Right? See, we are staying in one of the best community, like some of the best community, and we are inside very happy, everything. Does not mean somebody in the next lake, they are burning some solid waste or some plastics and all, that smoke will come to us also. Right? So we are staying in one harmony. We are staying together and see that those people also work there and they will also change. So SDG, whatever SDG is there, to implement the SDG, we are all prepared, Indians. All real estate, you know, companies, builders, everything, they're all on job. See, except a few people encroached Rajnalla, built in a buffer zone and all. See, there is a big issue also. Like so many people, they don't know where is the border. When governments do survey, properly fix the border, then only properly they know. Most of them mistakes. Some people purposefully, greediness they might have done. Not all, right? 80% of the people, they're perfect. That is why still Bangalore is alive. Right? Still any metro cities are alive. So all this COP26, whatever is there to reduce the temperature of 2 degrees Celsius, above water, below water, and you know, food for everybody. These are all, see, food for everybody, directly real estate only is now feeding. Right? Most of the unorganized sector, unskilled laborers, who is feeding? Not IT companies, definitely. IT companies will not going to give job for the, you know, fifth standard or sixth standard. You are the people who is giving employment. It is a big help for, and also highest taxpayers, right? In the country, whatever investment is happening, it is happening in real estate. So much of tax you are paying for the government. Because of that only government runs, right? So things are going in a very fantastic way. There is no doubt about it, but still let's work and let's be conscious and see that first is our nation, our planet, then these others. So nation and planet, we should be in our heart. So whatever possible, like for example, in every community you see, they are creating so much of awareness, like a utilization of water, every drop, they put a logo, symbol, and so much of things they do. I've seen it, like electricity consumption, you know, like use less electricity. Lot of awareness is available inside the community, but it should also spread outside unorganized infrastructure, whatever is there surrounding us. They are carelessly living. We should see that they will also live with careless so that all the SDGs will be followed. Yeah.
Okay. That's right. We don't, we shouldn't be, you know, in our silos, but it's a collective effort, as you said. Correct. And the unorganized segment, unorganized sector, I think that needs to be involved, the awareness. And, it's great to see that you are doing that on your part, you know, creating that awareness among others. And we wish you all the best for your ambitious plans for 2025 and reviving 35 more lakes. So thank you so much for being here with us and sharing your thoughts. And, you know, I'm sure our real estate community is very happy to hear what you have to say. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.